Hi all, we have some extra fun Leela games to go over from recently. So the Chesscom Computer Championship, the Blitz Bonanza final 5 minutes with a 2 second increment in round 10. Stockfish had won the first stage to get to this final and is now playing against three neural networks, and it's going to be pretty tough. Let's have a look at this game. So Leela ID 41800, so this is one of the very latest networks playing against Stockfish. E4, E5, the book given to them, the four knights, as the four knights come out, and now Bishop B5. We have Knight D4, white wants to preserve that bishop. Usually Bishop C4 was played. Another alternative is Bishop A4, this has been seen quite a lot. White taking on E5, coming back, it's thought to be about even actually. But Bishop C4 trying to keep control over that D5 square, Bishop C5, which is a kind of gambit now, and that's accepted. Knight takes E5. If white plays more modestly with D3, then this scenario is at least equal for black. This kind of scenario has been seen actually before. Black blasting through, dissolving the center a bit. Black can't take here because of Rook F1 and the backfire, but a move like King E7, black's fine. So we have Knight takes E5 instead of D3. Queen E7, Knight F3, and now D5. Bishop takes D5. Is white being too greedy here? If Knight takes D5, then Queen takes E4 check. This position, black's getting a lot of pressure after castling queenside, and it's at least equal. So Bishop takes D5, Bishop G4. This looks like a very, very nasty pin. And the problem with it also, this bishop cannot help on this diagonal. So is Leela in big, big trouble here? D3, C6, Bishop B3, Knight D7, Stockfish looks to be about to pile on the pressure on F3. This looks pretty grim. Is this going to be a quick loss for Leela? Bishop E3, we have Knight E5. Okay, guess what Leela plays in this position if I give you 5 seconds starting from now to pause the video. Okay, it looks as though there aren't too many options because this looks so strong taking on F3. So Knight takes D4, giving up the Queen. And now this forcing move, Knight F5. So it's going to be Queen for two pieces potentially, and of course a couple of pawns collected from earlier. Queen F8, Bishop takes C5. This is more accurate than Rook takes D1 because Bishop takes Knight takes. This position, black might be able to cause white some problems here. So that's a very, very complex position as well, but black's in better shape than in the game continuation taking here. So Rook takes D1 with the immediate threat of D4 forking. So black gets out of the way of that. Castling wouldn't help. There's still the fork with great effect. So Queen F8. Yes, this looks like a weird move to play, but where else? There's going to be a check potentially on D6 as well. So Queen F8, at least looking at D6. So D4, Knight G6. E5. So white's extra two pawns in the center are already kind of making themselves being felt, and the nice outpost on D6 with that E5 pawn, for example. So it's a very, very interesting queen sacrifice for two pieces and two pawns at this stage. It looks as though, yeah, this is very, very promising. Black castles queenside, kingside for Leela, of course. King B8, Knight E4. F6, F4, just supporting that E5 spearhead. Knight E7, Knight FD6, Knight D5. Rook DE1, stopping the knight fork there. And now pushing that knight back. And now reinforcing that D6 outpost. F takes, D takes. And we see here with D takes, actually white has a 4-2 pawn majority on the king side. Can this make itself felt later? A5, G3, Now we have after h6, knight f5, knight ed6. The knight's swapping positions there. Knight e6. And now this blockading knight is actually removed. Trying to win another pawn. Is this too greedy? What about white's king? Knight gf5, queen d5. Rook f2. And black takes that c5 pawn. But, yeah, the pawn majority is now 4-1 here in theory. But what about white's king? Rook d1, h5, king g2, h4. g4, keeping lines closed. a4, a3, queen b6. And now the king gets a bit adventurous with king f3. Fascinating. A move like h3 is also, it doesn't seem, for example, this is that bad. It seems as though black hasn't got too much to do in these scenarios. In any case, white's still better there. But king f3, rook d7, rook d3, rook e8, g5. These pawns are starting to be pushed. And they're gaining in weight, basically, in the value as they get closer to queening, potentially. And the knights, yeah, they're having a good time swapping positions. A reinforced outpost on f6 now. It looks as though if white had two moves now, just g6 and g7 supported by the knight on the destination square. Queen b5 hitting the rook. Queen c4. Now actually, knight d6 was played. Queen c1. King g4. Yes, this is very, very interesting. h3. Knight DE4. White could have actually just taken that pawn. It seems as though black hasn't got that much counterplay here. So knight DE4, queen C4, rook C2, queen A2. This is just weird, isn't it? Knight G3, rook E7, rook CE2. It seems as though white's really ready to push these pawns now. G6, F5. Yeah, this avalanche of pawns now. Black's trying to do something over here, it seems, but this stops or discourages c3 and actually blockades officially now with knight c3, and now taking this pawn. These pawns, yeah, the king's put back, the knight goes back to e4. Now this pawn comes up the board. Yeah, black's just spectating here as these pawns increase in mobility. f6. Yeah, sacrificing that pawn. G7. If queen g8, it looks as though h6 with f7 in mind, for as one example. We have queen h6, rook f5. Rook takes f6. This seems very desperate to give up an entire rook. If king b8, then believe it or not, rook d2 is not that ridiculous here, given the two connected passports on the 7th. So, for example, rook c8, rook d7, big advantage. And if black took here, yeah, this imminent f7 is so powerful here that it's just crashing through, really, with advantage. So rook takes f6, rook takes, queen takes g7, rook e f2, threatening rook f7 check. King gets out of the way, h6. And now rook f8, the queen's just left by herself against a rook and two knights. This doesn't look too good anymore. Well, not that it did earlier that much. And now, yeah, this looks like really there's nothing for black to do but just wait for this pawn to advance. So this pawn does start advancing. And yeah, white's just massive material up. In any case, black's not really doing much here. And the game, it carries on to the mate in this particular tournament. And let's see the technique. And so, yep, scooping up all the material. And now, final phase. giving up the knight, simplifying even further. Table base win. Checkmate. Yeah, so quite an interesting game there, very interesting game with the queen sacrifice. This is a line which often black's getting a lot of play, really. So very, very interesting to see this idea that f3 torture can be resolved just with a queen sack under certain circumstances. So if you enjoyed this game video, please click on the top left box, which should appear shortly, to become a member at chessworld.net, play against other YouTubers. You can also test yourself on the variations covered in this game and other games from the improved menu puzzle books option, which has a link to the annotated game as well. Comments, questions, donations, see the description. Like, share, subscribe with the notification bell. Really appreciate it. Thanks very much.